For two consecutive days, the presidential aspirant on a United Republican Party ticket, Eldoret North MP William Ruto, continued with his vote-hunting mission in the coastal region. Addressing several rallies in Bura, Tana River County, Ruto, who was accompanied by MPs allied to URP, said that if elected as the country's fourth president, he will ensure that there is equitable distribution of resources to improve the infrastructure and health sectors in the marginalized areas. Ruto also asked Kenyans to be more vigilant when electing their leaders by scrutinizing their past records.
Usifanye guesswork ile kubahatisha ama kucheza karata. Piga kura kwa viongozi ambao wako na historia na rekodi ya kufanya yale wanasema.
Ni chama cha URP ndicho huwa kinapigana na ufisadi. Kwa sababu ufisadi unarudisha nyuma maendeleo.
The local leaders present also endorsed Ruto's candidacy and the URP. Also in the coast, Deputy Prime Minister Uhuru Kenyatta continued with his campaign tour, addressing rallies in Lamu County. Kenyatta was accompanied by another presidential aspirant, Justice Minister Eugene Omalwa, in one of the rallies, said if elected, his presidency will deliver real change to better the lives of Kenyans, will improve the country's healthcare system, as well as empower the youth in equipping them with the necessary skills. Justice Minister Eugene Omalwa said that he's ready to work together with like-minded politicians for the sake of the unity of the country.
Kuhakikisha ya kwamba tumeweza kutatua shida zetu. Cha kwanza ni sisi viongozi tuhakikishe ya kwamba yale ambayo tutakuwa tunanena ni ya kuleta amani na umoja katika taifa letu la Kenya.
Lakini leo nataka niwahakishie ya kwamba poti inajengwa hapa Lamu. Na wakati poti hii inajengwa, tungependa vijana wa Lamu waweze kuwa wa kwanza kupata kazi kwenye poti yetu ya Lamu hapa.
Kwa hivyo nawaambia ndugu zangu, tusifanye siasa za kiroho, tukaacha siasa za kiakili.
Tumeangalia viongozi wote. Kwa sababu kila kiongozi akisimama anasema yale ataatenda. Lakini wengi wao ukiwaangalia vizuri si ile roho yao ya kusaidia mwananchi.
Meanwhile, presidential aspirant on a United Democratic Forum Party ticket, Deputy Prime Minister Musalia Mudavadi, continued with his campaign tour of the larger Mount Kenya region, where he addressed rallies in Maua and Meru Town. Mudavadi was accompanied by MPs allied to UDF, said that if elected as the country's fourth president, he will prioritize security by posting adequate officers in all corners of the country. Mudavadi, who was also given miraa by the locals as a sign of appreciation, promised to expand the market for the crop.
Tukipata nafasi ya kuongoza Kenya ni kuimarisha mambo ya security, ili zile pesa tunatenga kando kuenda kwa security agencies tuongeze hizo pesa ili wapate magari ya kutosha, tuhakikishe kwamba communication ya polisi iko sawa sawa, na tuhakikishe pia tunaajiri askari wa kutosha.
Yeye ndiye wamemtoa kuja kuomba kura huku, tuungane na nyinyi kwa sababu nyinyi ni ndugu zetu ambao walibaki huku.
Tusaidie ndugu Musalia Mudavadi kuwa president wa nne wa Jamhuri ya Kenya.
Elsewhere, Vice President Kalonzo Musyoka wound up his campaigns in Ukambani region, where he addressed rallies in his home turf of Mwingi North. Musyoka, accompanied by MPs allied to the Wiper Democratic Party, said the journey to change the country's leadership has already begun, promising that if elected president, he will ensure that the constitution is fully implemented so that to strengthen the national institutions. Kalonzo said he will work to eliminate corruption.
We will not only implement the new constitution, because therein lies true reform. In that document lies the true transformation, the formula for transforming this nation. Therefore, I firmly believe in this constitution.
Sisi tunajua kama jamii ya Wakamba peke yetu hatuwezi tukampeleka Kalonzo Musyoka kuwa rais wa Kenya.
And in Nairobi County, Prime Minister Raila Odinga was popularizing the ODM agenda when he attended the Orange Women Democrats League convention that brings together all women affiliated to ODM at the Bomas of Kenya. Odinga, who launched a similar league for the youth yesterday, said his main agenda is to develop Kenya and improve the livelihoods of all Kenyans, claiming that the sole agenda of his opponents was to block him from ascending to power. While promising to champion issues relating to women, Odinga, who was accompanied by MPs allied to ODM, argued that he is the only candidate in the presidential race with credentials to serve in the country's top position.
Tusema mpaka tubadilishe wakina mama mpaka wawe na haki ya kumiliki ardhi.
Out of that 117, we must be the majority. We will not be the majority women if we are playing games of PhD, pull her down.
You know, women have been discriminated against for many years.
Huyu bwana historia yake ukiona utabubujika na machozi.
The women at the convention resolved to go out to the grassroots level to campaign for Odinga and mobilize as many women as possible to support his candidature. And it is now official, presidential aspirant Cyrus Jirongo has politically parted ways with Eldoret North MP William Ruto, who is also presidential aspirant on a United Republican Party. Jirongo, who attended a burial ceremony in Shamahoko, Vihiga County, said he has ditched URP and will be launching his own party.
Nitaenda, nitasukuma, kwa sababu najua na ubongo wa kutosha. Hao ambao wanafikiri watapanga sisi. Alafu hivi karibuni, tutawatangazia chama ambacho mtaingia na itakuwa chama cha kitaifa.
And presidential aspirant on a rebuild and restore Kenya party ticket, former Education Permanent Secretary Professor James Ole Kiapi took his campaigns to Western Kenya. Kiapi, who had attended the Kenya National Union of Teachers annual general meeting in Shinyalu, Kakamega County, blamed corruption and poor leadership for the country's dismal performance in key sectors. While asking teachers to vote for him, Kiapi claimed that some corrupt politicians were using their influence to illegally acquire wealth to manipulate the outcome of the coming polls.
Political leadership has failed the country. It has failed the country because they think power is to go and amass wealth, and then you use wealth to amass more power, and use more power to continue amassing wealth.
And in Mount Elgon, Bungoma County, acting KANU chairman Gideon Moi claimed that presidential aspirants Eldoret North MP William Ruto and Deputy Prime Minister Musalia Mudavadi are statehouse projects who should not be taken seriously. Moi, who was popularizing the KANU party as well as meeting delegates allied to the party, asked the government to beef up security for Lugari MP Cyrus Jirongo for revealing the information.
Iko watu ambao leo wanasema wanataka urais.
KANU is set to hold its national delegates conference next month to elect its officials. Chris Thairu, Citizen Weekend.